Hi everyone, I'm Laura McNeil, CEO of Global Lyme Alliance. As an organization, GLA is committed to improving the quality of life of people suffering from Lyme and other tick-borne diseases. As part of that, it's our responsibility to keep you updated on the exciting advances that we've been making. So here are three GLA-funded research updates that you should know about. First, in my last video, you may have heard me talk about a potential new treatment for Lyme disease called hygromycin A. This week, GLA made another investment to try to bring this drug to market. We're working with a biotech firm called FlightPath, and this project is currently in its preclinical trial stage. It will be a multi-year effort to get this new therapy through the FDA, and it could be available by 2028. We're really excited about this research, as it could be the first new drug for Lyme disease in 30 years. Second, an exciting discovery from Monica Embers at Tulane University found the Lyme bacteria in a post-mortem brain tissue of a chronic neurological Lyme patient who was treated with antibiotics. This finding supports the hypothesis that Lyme can persist in patients even after extensive treatment, a hypothesis that many doctors do not believe to be true. We are funding Dr. Embers to expand on this study and continue the search. And third, GLA is excited to see progress in the development of a highly sensitive Lyme disease detection test that could help doctors diagnose the disease faster and more accurately. The test in development is with Ionica Sciences, and it's designed to quickly confirm the presence of the Lyme bacteria. This test is important because the current test only looks for antibodies, which can take up to 14 days to become detectable. And we know that the longer the patient goes without treatment, the higher the potential for significant, persistent symptoms. By directly detecting the bacteria that causes Lyme, the test will currently fill a blind spot in the time between infection and diagnosis. It can also allow for testing for reinfection and can help determine if a person is cured of active Lyme. These are just a few of the many projects in the works that can significantly impact the lives of suffering patients and help those in the future. To learn more about our work, please visit us on social or at gla.org.